You actually did an interesting experiment. Can you share something about that with us?
Well, we called it the Lessons of the Kobayashi Maru, which is a Star Trek reference for the audience. In the Star Trek episode, it was an unwinnable exercise, and young cadet James T. Kirk was forced or chose to cheat on an unwinnable scenario, and he reprogrammed the computer and was able to succeed in that exercise. So we wanted to put students in a similar scenario with the intent of deliberately forcing them to take on an adversary mindset. And mind you, the people that we did this were government employees that typically work 9 to 5 and they don't have this mindset, but they embraced it. What we asked them to do was to take a test. We gave them very little notice, and we told them the night before to, and that they were expected to cheat on the test. And if they were caught cheating, then they failed. They weren't supposed to study.
So cheating was allowed.
Cheating was expected.
Expected.
And the test itself was the first 100 digits of pi. So they had to recite the first 100 digits of pi or actually write them down. It actually worked out really well. I'll give you a couple of examples of their creativity. One of them created business cards. Well, actually had a stack and came up the next day before the test and was very proudly giving us their business card. The rest of the stack, it turned out, had the answer written on them. So this individual could have walked around in front of us and given one to every single student and given them all the answer. He chose not to, but he could have because he subverted our trust. Another example was someone who we allowed students to have soda cans on their desk, and they printed out the answer and put it on the side of the can. And when we would walk around, they would put their hand over the answers and then check the answers when our back was turned. And my personal favorite was a student who would take one of the books from the course, scanned in the back cover, loaded it in Photoshop, and ghosted in the answer, printed it out, trimmed it down, and used hairspray to tack it lightly to the back cover of the book. So it was is indistinguishable unless you closely looked at it. So they created an entire false book cover. But that's exactly what we were looking for. We wanted people to think like an adversary, look at, really it comes down to trust. Where do you place trust? Find those trust assumptions and subvert them.
So in this case, the proctor was the security system in some sense. So you were proctoring all this time and they were taking the test.
Yes, yeah, so when yeah. During the test, my colleague and I were proctoring it. And what was very funny, and granted, we weren't trying too hard to catch them cheating, but as we'd walk around the classroom, in front of us, we'd see the students staring up into the sky, considering the 73rd digit of pi. And behind us, we'd hear rustling, and then I'd slowly turn. Behind me were students contemplating the 67th digit of pi or the 82nd digit of pi. And then behind me, I'd start hearing rustling. But it was really really a good deal of fun. They embraced it. And, I mean, I could go on. It was just the innovation was off the scale. But I thought it was a useful and fun exercise.
Absolutely. I think sort of, so security we say is all about sort of assumptions and guarantees. And the assumptions have to be about the nature of the threat you're going to be dealing with.